My name is Artem Timoshenko. I'm a PhD candidate at the marketing group. And so my job market paper was about identifying customer needs from user-generated content. Let me give you an example. So think about a simple product category like oral care products. What do we want from oral care? Well, personally, I want from oral care whiter teeth, cleaner teeth, maybe healthier gums. But it appears to be that if we ask customers what they want from oral care products, there is a quite diverse set of customer needs. Some customers would say, I'm traveling a lot, so I need oral care products which are easy to carry around. Very relevant for many people in this room like half a year ago. Some customers will say, you know, I recently refurnished my bathroom, so I want oral care products which fit my bathroom decor. So for companies, for product development, it's very important to understand a diverse set of customer needs. This gives ideas for new products. And a typical study would be based on about 20 to 25 customer interviews, which would identify about 100 different customer needs, even for a simple product category like that. I understand many people in this room are not from the marketing background, so let me give you a little more motivation why we really care about customer needs. So imagine that you talk to your customers, and your customers say, you know, I really like this toothbrush, but it's not red. So one way to proceed is you go to your engineers and ask them, can you please develop the red toothbrush for me? Another way is you actually go back to the customer and say, why do you want the red toothbrush? And it might appear that several options, right? One option is that people want the red brush toothbrush because it doesn't fit their bathroom decor. So there is some aesthetic component in that. Another case is that they want red toothbrush because their kids find red toothbrushes more entertaining. So if you just went to your engineers and asked them to develop the red toothbrush, in the first case, it doesn't really satisfy the exact customer need because aesthetic could be much broader and you could develop much better products than just the red toothbrush. In the second case, it's not also about the red toothbrush. It might be the red toothbrush for this particular kid. But in general, for the market, it might be that you want to develop toothbrushes with Mickey Mouses, not really the red toothbrushes. So going deep from the level of understanding custom product attributes and product characteristics to the level of understanding the underlying customer benefits is very important in marketing. It's very important. It has implications for product development. It has implications for marketing communications. So because we are talking about this abstract underlying level of customer benefits, the traditional approach for identifying customer needs is based on the interviews and focus groups. So in our research, I wanted to explore two things, basically. One is, can we use online reviews, online content to identify the similar set of customer needs? And the second question was, can we do it more effectively using some machine learning tools? So to address the first question, I partnered with a marketing consulting firm. The firm has over 25 years of experience in the market research. And I asked them about two sets of data. One is, I wanted them to provide me a list of customer needs they identified in a focal line study based on the interviews. The second piece, I downloaded Amazon reviews for the same category of products. It was for oral care, for the same category of products, sampled some part of it, and asked the same company, but a different set of analysts, to review these reviews and identify the list of customer needs. So I was able to compare these two sets of customer needs identified on the interviews and online reviews. We found that in the case of oral care products, two sets significantly overlap. Majority of customer needs appear in both sources of information, and it appears to be that if we considered a little more reviews, we would actually be able to almost perfectly replace interviews and focus groups from this process. We would be able to identify the same customer needs from the online content. So it appears to be that online content contains a lot of valuable information about customer needs, and it would be good for us if we were able to identify them more effectively. The challenge with online content, though, is that there's just so much of it, and it's extremely noisy. If you're just looking at the Amazon reviews for oral care products, there are over 300,000 Amazon reviews for oral care products. It's toothbrushes, mouthwashes, flosses. 300,000 reviews. Humans are not able to process that, and the content is very noisy. So we need some content selection mechanism or some ways to facilitate the identification of customer needs by the humans. So in this paper, we propose an approach which uses machine learning to pre-screen content and select which content we submit to the humans. And then we rely to human judgment to formulate the underlying customer needs. I'll obviously not go into technical details in this 10-minute talk, but just to give you some intuition about what's going on. Consider the following Amazon review. So the customer complains that she replaced an old brush with a new one, but the 32nd timer is missing. The brush shuts off after 2 minutes, but the 32nd timer, not the 32nd timer, the toothbrush, and she would not have purchased this product if she had known. Well, two things we learned from this review. One is a 32nd timer is really important for this customer. We might guess that the underlying customer benefit, what the customer really wants from the 32nd timer, is she wants to know the exact amount of time to spend on different steps of the oral care routine. Okay, so the step from understanding the attribute, the product attribute, to understanding the underlying customer benefit, this is best done by the human judgment. It requires you to relate to the customer experience. But then the other point is, if you're just interested in formulating customer benefits like that, we don't really need to read the entire review. We could notice that the first two sentences communicate the same information in terms of this customer need. And the last sentence just communicates how important this customer need is for the customer. So instead of considering the entire review, we could just focus on the first or the second sentence. And so this is the idea of the machine learning approach. We choose which sentences we want to provide to the humans, and then analysts help us to formulate the customer needs behind those. So this approach helps us to improve efficiency of identifying customer needs. It appears to be that it takes about 20% less time to identify the same set of customer needs from Amazon reviews compared to without machine learning. If you think about social media data, which is more noisy, and there will be more irrelevant sentences like that, then machine learning benefits are even more pronounced. So another interesting thing here is it appears to be that machine learning is mostly important in identifying rarely mentioned customer needs. So some customer needs are so frequent, like customers would be talking about the same problems and features and experiences again and again. And so some customer needs are so frequent that you can just go with a random selection of content and you would identify them almost perfectly with a certain number of sentences. The rare customer needs which are rarely formulated by the customers, this is where the primary benefits are coming from. And notice, rare customer needs are not less important. It appears to be that importance and performance of the products don't really correlate with the frequency of mentions of customer needs. But our competitors are very, very likely to miss those. So it's very important that we are able to identify rarely mentioned customer needs. So we proposed this approach about 2 years ago, and some companies adopted it. There were some applications in different industries which we observed. And I wanted to share one of the interesting insights from those. So in our case with oral care, we found out that in oral care case, we were able to almost perfectly replace interviews and focus groups with the online content. It appears to be that for most categories of products, it will not be true. There will be very significant overlap, and the majority of customer needs will be in both types of information, but there will be some complementarity between online content and interviews. But even more, it appears to be that different types of online content, say social media data, articulate somewhat different customer needs than Amazon reviews. We might provide some hypotheses. We have not tested them in the paper, but the message is we want to process not just Amazon reviews or not just online reviews, but we actually want to explore a very broad set of different online content. So if I want you to remember just two things from this short talk. For marketing, it's very important to go to this underlying level of understanding customer benefits. And online content sounds like a very valuable source of information for those. We can use machine learning to facilitate human judgment and identify customer needs more efficiently. And machine learning doesn't replace humans, but actually helps to facilitate and make them more efficient. I will stop here. Thank you.